Welcome to the Mobile Themes and Templates session. In this session, we'd like to cover a number of topics, including the Silk UI themes and templates that are available, which would be the phone, tablet, and universal. We'd like to talk about the properties of themes, and each theme has layouts. So the layout that is available for a theme defines the different types of components that are in that theme. And that theme is then supported by different types of common user interface elements. So we will talk about all of the different pieces that make up the themes that help us define the look and feel of the screens and the user interfaces that we create. So we've mentioned that there's the silkui.outsystems.com website, and that the templates and themes are available in the main link at the top. So we can get to the phone template and the tablet template, download those, and be able to use them inside of our OutSystems server. So as we begin creating new applications, one of the things that will happen is it will ask you to select a template for your app. So if you choose a mobile application, it will say, do you want a phone, a tablet, or a universal template? And it will go ahead and define that as the theme that it's going to use from that point forward. So once Service Studio opens and we begin to look at our module, if our module was the module name, so here we have a module called module name, there are a bunch of defaults inside of the module that help define its look and feel and the way it's going to behave. So here you can see the theme gets the exact same name as the module. So our module's name is module name, and our theme gets that exact same name. It does say that there's a default screen for this app, and that's the home screen in the main flow. There's a splash screen for this app in the common flow, and inside of the common flow there's an exception handler that handles all of the things that might occur, default transition, and a default timeout of 10 seconds for any type of server request. There are also validation messages and other types of things, but when we think about the look and feel of our app, a lot of that is defined by the module and how it's going to work, and a good bit of that is which theme are we using for this particular module. So if we look at the theme's properties, if we weren't looking at the module itself, but we went down to the theme which is called module name, the module name has the base theme that it's based upon as the phone theme. And you can see that this module name theme has its own style sheet. It has a grid type, which is fluid, but it's inheriting that from the phone theme, and then it has a particular type of layout. So when we create a new module, it gets its own theme, and that theme is basically defined by the styles, the grids, and the layouts of how it is set up. Now in this case, it's basically building upon the phone theme. So themes, because they're based partially on styles, do cascade. So in this particular case, we built a module called module name, and it's based on the phone theme. But if we actually went in and looked at the phone theme itself, which is available under themes under the mobile patterns, the phone theme is based on the base theme. So there is a base theme that we can base the phone and the tablet types of templates upon, and then those phone and tablet templates or themes can be extended when we create our own modules. So that same type of cascading thing that we may be familiar with in cascading style sheets, because part of the themes are style sheets, we get that same type of capability. So how would we get to see the style sheets that are helping define our theme? Well, if we came in and we wanted to say, since our module is based on the phone theme, what does the phone theme's style sheet look like? Well, we could get to that relatively easily by double-clicking on the style sheet, and it would open the style sheet in the style sheet editor, and it would show us what the phone theme looks like. And there's a lot of different things in here. There's some setup for text and image formatting, there's some layout of the pages, controls for buttons and forms and different types of validations, and then all of the widgets and silk blocks and patterns, as well as utility classes and colors. So the base theme, in this case the phone theme, which isn't the actual base theme, but this base theme for us has quite a lot of definitions about what is out there. And we could get to that either by looking at the theme itself, but for each screen, the screen is going to be inheriting the theme of the application. So the theme defines the overall look and feel. Here we can see a home screen, and it has some sort of default look and feel. It's got a blue header and things like that. If we wanted to see how this home screen's styles have been set up, we can either click inside of the editing area at the top where the style editor is, or we can just double click on the styles down below. And it will go ahead and open a set of tabs. And in this case, what we showed before is that the home screen is part of our module. The module is basing its theme on top of the phone theme, which is based on top of the base theme. So if we wanted to start at the bottom and look at everything that's there, we could see all of the types of elements that are defined in the base theme. We'd then be able to step up and look at the phone theme and see what the phone is overriding and changing in the base theme, how it's extending it, and then we could get to the module. And this is where it can tell that we're customizing the phone theme. And because when we created our app, we chose a color. So the primary color here is now available, and it's available both for the links and the menus and the header area. So it begins customizing the default phone theme to be able to do things. Now, one thing that's interesting to note, if I go back for just a second, the phone theme is grayed out and has green text. Both the phone theme and the base theme are part of the overall templates, and we can't edit these directly. What we can do is, inside of the module, override or change some of the capabilities for the phone or the base theme and define those here. And then above the module, each individual screen could customize some of what's happening, and we could go ahead and do that here. So we could customize anything because we're inheriting everything off of the module name, and then we could customize those pieces here. So lots of interesting things happening in the styles. Now let's talk about the layouts. So we said that the themes are sort of defined by the styles and how things are going to look as far as look and feel with the colors, but also how does the layout work? And we can see that the home screen by default, with the theme that we've chosen, gets the common layout. And the common layout has a title area, some header areas, and then a content area. So the home screen has this basic layout where there are some placeholders for us to put different types of content. Now the layout itself is a layout block. So again, if I go back real quickly, you can see that the common layout is a block that is going to be definable. And when we open that layout block, which is from the common area, you can see that there are a lot of different things inside of it. There are variables to configure how it works. There are actions that control its life cycle and help with some of the event handling. And then there are these placeholders where we would be able to put content. And then the description of the layout block below shows the different types of life cycle events that can occur and whether or not we want to interact with any of them. And you can see by default the layout does worry about the on ready event that is inside of the life cycle of the screen. So the layout block has a lot of information about how it's going to sort of do its work. If we open the layout to see, given this layout, where are all of these placeholders and information, the menu is at the top. So the menu is a common block that goes ahead and makes the menu available. Now what we see here is actually the menu icon. So the menu will slide out, because it's a page overlay, when we go ahead and interact with the icon. So again, these are common elements. There is a utility on the page that says if someone sort of pulls on the page, it will pull to refresh. So that's been built into the overall layout. The bottom bar can be used to store things and maybe put icons for navigation. And then below everything, there's an offline data sync block. So you can see that we begin using the layout block and we use other blocks inside of it to go ahead and build up the overall functionality of the page so that the home screen inherits lots of things like pull to refresh and data synchronization and the menus and the icons. So the layout gives us those capabilities. If we wanted to see some of those individual blocks, those blocks are in the common UI flow, and you can see that the layout that we've been working with does have access to the menu and the menu icon blocks, the bottom bar block, this offline data sync block. So these are all part of the common area. If we want, the icon will change from the hamburger to go back when we begin navigating, so there are menu actions that are part of the menu icon, and the menu icon is helping us control the menu. And the menu is that overlay, and this would slide out, and it would allow us to see, by default, information about the user, potentially log in or log out at the bottom, and then in here we'd be able to put all of the different screens we'd like to be able to navigate to from the menu. So we'd have to customize this and add things to it, but there's lots of things that are available, and we can customize the way the menu is going to render and look. It has a lot of different variables, and it can react to different types of gestures. So there is some ability for us to kind of work with the menu and customize it if necessary. We also have the bottom bar block, which is down at the bottom, but when you double click, it opens that small area up at the top of the editor, and the bottom bar is going to be able to hold different types of information. By default, we would use the mobile pattern from Silk UI called the bottom bar item. And the bottom bar item gives us a place to put an icon and some text so that we can quickly go ahead and create these items and then probably add links to them so that we can navigate to different areas from the bottom bar, because that's where people sort of have the easiest places to reach with their thumb and some of the navigability of working with the phone. Now the last piece is the offline data sync block, and this will help us when we are offline to go ahead and, if we're storing things, eventually when we get back online, we're going to want to be able to do synchronizations. So this block is a fairly complicated block that has a lot of interesting information about it, and there's a special section just on this because it can do things like detect changes in the network and then trigger whether it should do synchronizations or not. So these blocks can be a little bit complicated just on their own. We're getting all of this built into the layout because we chose a particular theme and template. Now, you may be saying, I want to design my own page and I don't need all of that stuff. Well, those blocks are there and you can reuse them at any time you might need them. So instead, you may wish to use what we call Layout Blank. And Layout Blank only has one set of capabilities built in, and that is the offline sync block. So the Layout Blank is completely blank. It just has a container at the bottom holding the synchronization capabilities. And if you really didn't want those, you could go ahead and create a even more blank layout. But this is nice to have, and you can configure the data synchronization to happen when you want. So this is truly the blankest and simplest type of layout that you can work with. So you may choose to go ahead and do that. Now there are some other common UI elements. So we did look at the common UI area, and we looked at the layouts with all of these other blocks that are available to us. And you can see all of those here. So if we opened up the common UI, it would show us all these blocks and the ability to redirect to different URLs. But there are also three screens available, the splash screen, the login screen, and the invalid permission screen, and some exceptions. So those are also sort of made available to us as part of the setup for our themes and templates. And when we look at the exceptions, there's a communication exception so that if we don't get information back from the server during that timeout, and we looked earlier, we said the timeout was set to 10 seconds by default, then it will go ahead and throw a communication exception. It can catch all of the other types of exceptions, and it also looks for security exceptions. So if you try to get to a particular page, it can check your user ID and you may not have permission to be able to get to that page, and if you don't, we'll end up on the invalid permissions page. So handling the exceptions is useful, and we should have a sort of highest level way to handle that, and that's what we have in our common on exception area. Now we also have the different screens. For a mobile app, you'd want a splash screen. You probably want people to log in, so you need a login screen. And then again, if security occurs, you want to be able to say, hey, you don't have permissions to view the required screen. Go back and log in and change things. They may be logged in as a different user. But here we have a splash screen that will show us loading the application and the resources. We'll have the ability to log in on the login screen and then get the security exceptions from the invalid one. Splash screen is relatively simple. It will go ahead and track loading all of the resources that it needs. It will also show the progress on updates. So when we upgrade an application and make changes to it, if we're not changing significant parts of the structure, it will automatically upgrade the app itself. So it will also show us the upgrading status of how it's working. For the phone theme, we may wish to log in. So we have a default login. And once we have the ability to log in, the login screen will call the server and make sure that we are authenticated as far as who we are. There is this little eye that will show us the password so that as we're typing it in, if we can't see it and we seem to have typed something wrong, we could go back and look at that. And when we think about logging in, once we log in, we do want to call the server. So here's a do login server action. But once we log in, we may wish to synchronize all of the data because we may have been offline or doing work, and we may wish to then make sure that we are in sync with the server. So to do that, once we log in, it will check the offline data configuration to see whether or not we should sync when we log in. So one of the settings that can be set is automatically sync when we log in, and if that happens, then we will call sync on login to go ahead and do that. And syncing on login calls our offline data sync capability, and as long as we sync successfully, it will take us to the next page that we had asked to go to during the login process. If it doesn't work properly and we have some sort of exception, it will automatically log us out. So if we have it configured to sync, we log in successfully, but we don't sync successfully, it will still log us out and give us the exception message of what went wrong. And then finally, we talked about the invalid permission screen, where it's just going to show us the blank slate saying you tried to get to something and you are a registered user, or you're an anonymous user and you can't get to that information. So in this section on themes and templates, we looked at the properties of themes and templates, which include the style sheets that help define how it's going to look, the layout that structures the overall pages, and then some of the other things that are available from the theme, like the splash screen and the login screen. So there's a lot of information here, and the theme gives us a great head start with all of these resources, but it will take some time to get familiar with and get comfortable with these resources. So it's important that you go back and work with these and look at them a little bit more so that you're able to use them very effectively.